What is up, everyone? It's Funk Monkey here. Welcome back to the channel today, and I hope you're having a really, really good day. I'm here today joined with
Joey.
Nice. Well, of course, he's one of our crew members, but the other two crew members couldn't join today, so we gave them a small little break. But we wanted to talk about two subjects that are very, very interesting in our opinion. Of course, one is about the important exports DLC that should be coming out next Tuesday. And of course, something that me, Joey, and the others have been working on for... Well, I've been working on most of it.
Because you've never asked me to join.
Oh, well, anyways. Let's start with the show. Do you want to talk about the show? It's not going to take that long, I think.
I don't know exactly what you want me to go into, but whatever.
Okay, let's start with that anyways. So, if you guys have seen my previous vlogs, I've mentioned that we were probably going to replace the movie with something that we will essentially like more than the movie. And it's essentially a car show. We're doing a car show mainly on GTA. It's gonna be the four of us, which is of course me, Joey, Josh, and of course Beth. And it's something that we're very excited about. I mean, I've been excited. Joey, you've been really excited for this.
I did make a track for you.
Yes. And we're going, god damn it, turn down your volume.
Shut the fuck out, go.
We are going full out on this. God damn it, Joey.
Fucking old JT, man.
Then turn down the volume.
I know. Okay, continue.
Right, we're getting off topic. So what this car show is essentially going to be is this. I want this car show to be out there and competitive against other car show YouTubers for GTA, if that makes sense. And surprisingly enough, this is a project that I'm going to be going to college with. This is part of my college plan, that when I go there, I'll show them, look, ma bitches, I got this. I've been working on it for the entire summer. And it's kind of proving a big challenge. I mean, we were testing out the track, and the track is beautiful, guys. I can't actually wait for you guys to actually try it out. Is it public, Joey, at the moment?
Yeah, it's all published. Right,
we will probably link the track in the description down below, just so you guys can try it out. Of course, this is our first track ever, so bear in mind we are not stunt racers or content race creators. But anything you want to say about the show, Joey?
It's really just gonna be a great show. We are going to be putting hours and days, maybe months, into planning and all of that, and we really hope you enjoy everything we do for it.
Exactly. And just to let you know, guys, this is no like one-off show. Like, we have at the moment 3 people working on the first five episodes of season 1, so this is going to be full with seasons. There's going to be days where we're going to be recording non-stop. That's going to be very epic. And what else? I think that's pretty much it. We are trying to get, of course, a theme song for the show. So if you guys want to submit maybe a song that you created and be part of this show, send us a link to either SoundCloud or something so we can actually hear your song. And we'll maybe use it for the car show. And that's essentially much it. We'll keep you guys updated on the car show later on in the future. But what are we going to be talking about is the DLC, the import and export DLC. And I'm so bloody excited for this DLC. What do you think?
I it's It is really hard for me to express how happy I am for the DLC, especially because it's something a lot of us have been waiting for. I believe, if I read correctly, over 60 cars are going to be added into the game.
No, there's going to be 25 cars.
25, okay.
With a 60-car garage.
That's okay.
That's fucking huge. If they allow us to literally buy more than one 60-car garage, I'm going for it.
That's because you're a rich motherfucker. Anyway.
Trust me, 24 million is not enough on this game.
Still, I'm still down here at 300,000.
Yeah, and we wanted to essentially talk about this DLC because me and Joey were debating on this DLC. By the
not,
way,
not
it,
too
is
long.
For, it is it has been leaked that the Trifade Nero is going to be the EB110, which is the older Bugatti. You know, you probably know which one that is.
If not, just pop it on the screen.
Exactly. So, the EB110, I don't know if I should be happy that they're adding an older version of a Bugatti car, or sad. Because, in my opinion, right, back in... Like, what's it called? 2013? Yes. 2013. The car that everyone used to own was an Adder. For the simple fact it was a Bugatti.
Mm-hmm.
And, in my opinion, the next step, of course, logically, would be the successor to the Bugatti in real life, which is actually the Chiron. But it looks like Rockstar is not going for that route. They're going for EB110 style car, but it's going to be customized in Bennies.
And everyone knowing from the Lowriders update, that's going to be a whole lot of money.
That's why everyone is being overprepared, including me, about this DLC. I mean, no one knows. Like, there's a lot of Bennies cars coming to this in this DLC. So we're just praying that a lot of them won't be at all that expensive. But considering it's Rockstar and of course it's going to involve Bennies, it's going to be expensive as hell.
I feel like they're, like, as said in the past podcast, they're just trying to gain profit, and they do that by setting high prices in game to where then people want to buy that.
But here's the thing, not a lot of people have access to buy shark cards.
So exactly.
The thing is, well, there was a video that explained that the high increase was because of all the modded accounts. But considering the fact that now Rockstar have taken most of the modded accounts out and literally banned, like, drained them from their money, it doesn't look like it never, it, like, that wasn't the case. It was a fluctuation in, of course, prices, which is makes completely sense. But still, I don't, like, one card that I don't think it should be ranked that much, the Ruiner, which is going to be the kit car in the game. $5.7 million for a reskin of a Ruiner. That's a lot of money.
I mean, that would mainly depend on... Alright, for the original price of the car, yes, it should not be $5.7 million. But, if you were to take that into Bennies and
it's
give it
going,
the
it's
up...
Going to be in Bennies.
But if... Car. I said if, motherfucker. If it were to be Bennies upgradable, and you could put... I don't know, fucking rockets or some shit on it. That would then be a reasonable price, but
yeah,
just
but
for the Ruiner itself, it should not be 5.7.
But here's the thing, right? They mentioned some stuff that makes sense that this Ruiner is going to have that no other car in the game is going to have. This Ruiner is going to be able to jump. It's going to have a parachute, so literally you're falling from the sky and you can have a parachute deploy. Brent is going to have missile, like homing missiles. It can fly. And this is what essentially they said. Like, there was one Rockstar employee that leaked everything. He said that this was essentially Rockstar's answer to the jet griefers. In a way, seeing it like that, it makes sense. But everyone knows a Ruiner is like 15,000 if you buy it off the Southern San Andreas Super Hollows website.
Mm-hmm.
But 5.7 million for just weapons, that's a lot. And not to mention, there's going to be a rocket Voltic. Like the Voltic we have at the moment, Joey. Strap a rocket on the top of it. That's essentially it. I don't know how, like, the price of that, how it's gonna be, but it's probably gonna be extremely high, considering the fact that the Ruiner's 5.7 million. Let me bring up the list as well. One car I'm looking forward to is the Lamborghini Centenario, which is the Pegassi Tempesta. Now, it does make sense because a lot of people were saying it's a Huracan, but it's probably a mix between the Huracan and the Centenario, considering the fact Huracan in Italian means hurricane, of course.
Yeah.
So it makes sense that it's a Lamborghini Tempesta, but it has a lot of siding from the Centenario, and I'm really happy for that. I mean, the Centenario is a really good looking car.
For like indeed.
For like a reskinned, what you call it, Aventador.
Yeah. You can't remember shit. Anyway.
But yeah, that's okay. Now I've loaded up the list. So let's see what cars they said there's gonna be. So there's gonna be, of course, the R34 Skyline.
Oh my god.
This car will officially. I don't know how many people did it, but I did like a video a few months ago saying my car wish list. If the Trufate Nero and the Elegy are the R34 Skyline and the Bugatti Chiron, oh my god. Like, they've hit two cars from my hit list, like, car list. But.
Go
ahead.
I don't think that Rockstar really thinks about that. They just think about cars that a lot of people want needed to be imported.
I agree with you on that, though, because Rockstar what they're doing is what no other company does, is they go in forums and see what the community wants. Like, the R34 Skyline has been mentioned probably since the first day GTA was announced, right?
Yeah.
And so, not only that, they're adding a Benny's version to it, so that's going to be insane. If it's going to have a wide body kit or anything, probably it will. Moving on to the list here, the list I have in front of me. This was leaked by Jan on, when was it? Posted 6 days ago. Of course, we mentioned Lamborghini Tempesta is going to be a supercar. Then they're bringing out a ProGen. Now, they're saying it's going to be the 675 LT. Which would be pretty dope. I love that car. And it's gonna be a Benny's version as well. So there's a lot of supercars on this list that are going to be, they're gonna have a Benny's version.
That's what's gonna call for the high price points.
Exactly. So if they go what I think they're going to do, and they probably do it just like they did in Lowriders. The base price for the cars would be okay-ish.
Ish.
But the high price is going to be in the Benny's customizations. Which makes sense. Because probably a lot of people will actually buy the cars and just leave them without the upgrades. Especially the Dubache Spectre. They're saying this is the Aston Martin DBS. Oh, if they add that car. Ooh. Now, it could be the DBS or the DB10. They're saying it's probably one of the James Bond cars. But they, for some reason, right? Because people want the JB700 in the game, the one with the miniguns on top, the functioning miniguns. What I think, though, they will do is they're using the Ruiner. I've mentioned this like in a lobby because I was in the lobby for a few seconds. They're probably using the Ruiner as like the bait to see what the reaction of the community would be, and maybe they introduce the JB700, something
Maybe.
like that. I mean,
It's a possibility, but it's not likely.
yeah, but you have to keep in mind the Ruiner 2000 is going to be the first ever car in GTA to have weapons on it that you can literally drive and shoot at the same time.
Without having your handguns, but with
Which
Rockstar,
one?
it's not really predictable
Yeah.
because you might have to buy ammo in a shop for that. You never know. They're not just gonna let you have unlimited ammo in a vehicle.
I think
It's
it will
not gonna
have
work.
unlimited, in my opinion, it will have unlimited ammo. I mean, if you think about it, this, like, would argue with that, what you call it, subject you're talking about, why the insurgent, the one with the turret, has infinite ammo.
Okay, you got me there, but this isn't a military grade vehicle.
I
This is
in my
a fucking James
it will
Bond car.
probably it will probably be considered as like a military grade vehicle, but it is in the sports category. So this is something that Rockstar are doing lately. They're moving cars and putting them in different categories. The Ruiner, which is a muscle car, is now moved to sports, so it's going to be competing with the Sacro, the Jester, the Elegy. Is going to be competing with a lot of high-end sports cars. Now imagine that car, right? In a GTA race.
With
That's gonna be chaos.
that would be extreme chaos, and you would have quite a lot of people raging out because of it.
Probably. Let's see. There's gonna be two a bike, apparently a bike introduced, which is the Principe Diablis. I don't know a lot about bikes, so it's gonna be a sports bike. And again, it's going to have customization just like in Benny's. This might be the first bike that goes in Benny's, probably.
It is.
Yeah, it is, because there's no other bike that goes in Benny's. And let's see. Oh yeah, the Phantom Wedge, which essentially is the semi truck but with like a snow pile in the front. Oh my
Like one of
god.
the,
Just you see Mad Max, right?
yeah, like one of the
Grab
Mad
that
Max vehicles.
semi, put like a train style, like, what you
Snowplow?
call it? Yeah.
Or a cone
That's
plow,
it.
whatever the fuck you want to call
That's going to be insane.
them. That is actually quite believable from Rockstar, though, because from what they've put in so far, the big race truck for
The
sports.
Doom?
Yeah.
I don't know about the Doom, because here's the thing. The Doom, for people that bought it, like one of them is me, I feel ripped off, because of course you can't upgrade it, and there's no point in using it in free mode, and the only place you can use it is in a race. I figured that out after I bought it. But now I'm stuck with it. So I'm hoping
Wow.
they might introduce something that can actually sell Pegasus vehicles, because I need to sell a lot of Pegasus vehicles and gain some money back.
Yeah, because there's a lot of Pegasus vehicles no one uses anymore, and you just don't want to be stuck with those. You want to get your money back.
Exactly. The Rocket Voyotech, because I'm looking at it in the list as well, is the first car to have introduced a new category. Is gonna have an its own category, which is weird, because how are you gonna use it? Are you gonna use it in super, like supercar races, but without the, of course, the engine rockets, or maybe you can't use it at all. I mean, it's gonna be considered as a special vehicle, probably, but
If it's considered a special vehicle, I would expect it to come from Pegasus or another
but
new
it won't.
company.
That's the thing, because the warehouse, the way that the warehouse is going to work, is it's going to house the 60 cars that you own, right? But then it's going to add the special vehicles. So the special vehicles will have a layer of garage space for their own.
That's weird.
It kind of makes sense though. I mean, think about it. You need the special vehicles pronto, ASAP. So let's say, for example, you're going to do a cell mission and you have one of the cars going out. Maybe your crewmates can go in the special vehicles, grab them, and get ready. And basically escort the car out of the city and for the cell mission. That's what probably is going to happen. And sorry. the Onslaught Penetrator. Oh my god, I can't believe I said that. That's what it's called, the Onslaught Penetrator, which is the Jaguar XJ220, the old, like, very cool looking supercar that once was a, like, my dream car. That's going to be in super as well. I don't think it will be performing as good as like the top tier supercars. Maybe in, it's going to be as like one of those middle tiers. What do you think? We're talking about like an old school supercar here.
That's tough because I mean it could go if it's an old school kind of car, it could go in many categories, but you never know. Like if we take the Hockey Cho drag for example, supposedly the fastest car fastest vehicle in the game. And from a drag vehicle, that's not really expected. But then if we bring in an old style vehicle with supposedly old style engine parts and all of that, you never know. Especially if we take into account the me think of a name here.
Which one are you thinking of?
Who in the hell? The
Is it in the
shit.
game?
Yeah, the Sterling GT. The
Oh.
Benefactor Sterling GT. That's kind of an older in style car, and it was still decently fast.
You know, they moved that car for some reason in the sports category, right?
Yeah.
Like, that's fucking weird. But yeah, there's a lot of cars I'm really looking forward to. Like, continue on going down the list. There's another one, which is the MTL Wastelander. So this sounds like a truck, right? But it's in the sports category. And it boggled my mind. A truck in the sports category that's competing with supercar, like sports cars, proper sports cars. So I'm kind of interested on how they will take that. I mean,
You don't know what's under the hood of a car until you actually look under every nook and cranny of the car.
Yeah,
So.
the MTL in the game is the one that brought the MTL Dune and the MTL Brigade, those huge ass fucking trucks. So, for them to introduce an MTL Wastelander, like for a sports category, is tough because it has to compete with, again, the Massacros. What's the 177? The Davache 770 and Comets. What else? What's the high tier sports cars?
High tier
Elegies.
LG, the
Jesters.
entity.
No, the Entity is a sport, like supercar.
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought it was marked under the super sports category.
No, it never
You
was in a sports category.
noob. I never drove that thing. Shut up.
Oh, but it's a good car.
Never drove the thing.
So you were saying about the Wastelander.
You never know, Tim. You never know.
I'm thinking that it's probably like sort of a Ford Raptor, maybe.
Maybe, but that's hard to determine without seeing a visual of the vehicle.
Yeah, that's why we're looking for like a trailer this week, but they never announced one. Assholes.
Thought they did announce one, but they just didn't release it.
Yeah, they'll probably release it tomorrow, like they did it once where they showed the trailer on the 18th, on the not and the DLC was for the 19th, and they got a lot of hate for it. Like, a lot of people couldn't prepare for it and all that crap, apparently. But, oh, we just reached 10 million! Yes!
Wow, asshole.
So, besides the Pegassi Tempesta, there's going to be another bike, which is the Pegassi FCR 1000. Again, I don't understand a lot about bikes, but the bikes that are in the Pegassi family, of course, they're not Lamborghini, because Lamborghini never made bikes. And I'm trying to figure out what bike company it might be. Is
What
there
kind of
any?
bike is it?
It's a sports bike. God damn it, JT.
Sports bike. That can be a lot. That can be Yamaha, that could be Honda,
Could
could
be, but
be Ducati.
if they class it under Pegassi, right? It's probably an Italian sports bike. So I'm
I
thinking
would be thinking
Ducati.
Ducati.
So something along the Ducati would probably be. But I'm gonna be moving on to something I'm excited for, and I'm hoping that it's actually true. Is the classic Pifter Comet, which is called the Comet Retro Custom. Now this is going to be an old star. I said oil for fuck's sake. An old school Porsche 911. Oh my god! Like, if it's going to be as good as it sounds, I'm gonna be very, very happy. I'm gonna be a child like in Christmas. What do you think? Now they are saying, and I highly think it will happen. This is going to ha be the first Pifter like car that would have an RWD body kit on it. So just like in the Tuners and Outlaws DLC trailer concept, there was that wide body Comet. This could have a wide body to it. What do you think?
I think, I mean, I don't know. The wide body might be optional. It might not exist, or it might automatically be on the car. But with this new DLC,
You'll never
it
know.
should be coming with a lot of customizations.
But don't you think, right? Don't you think? I've been saying this ever since it was released. When they introduced the Sultan and the Banshee to Benny's, right?
Mm-hmm.
I've always said in live streams and even in videos, I even probably did a video back then, that that could lead to something bigger. Those cards were probably the test subjects to something bigger, which is this one. When you think of a custom Porsche, let's call it a Porsche, because we all know it's a Porsche, of course. When you think of a Porsche, right, and it's going to have customization to it, it's going to have an RWB body kit, or even a white, like a version of a white body kit. You cannot add like a classic Porsche and say we're calling it a custom without adding the wide body version of it, when a lot of people on GTA want wide bodies on the game.
You know, like with the, let's go back to the Sultan and the Banshee. You take that into Benny's and you make it a custom, you can then put a wide body on it. So maybe that's what they're going to do with the Porsche, and that may piss people off because they're going to have to buy the wide body, but ultimately, in the end, they're going to be happy because they have it.
You're paying for the DLC, as in, you're getting the DLC for free, so I wouldn't complain. I never complained about the DLC, because we'll be moving on to the subject that we had a few days ago, Joey, the subject about the whole thing. You can't go pretending that you're not going to be spending money for the wide body kit for a Porsche. Obviously, you're going to have to pay for it.
If you're a millionaire, that's not even a dent out of your bank account. But if you're broke and you really love the Porsche and you want the wide body, you're gonna get a little shitty.
I get your point, but at the same time, we're talking about GTA.
Indeed.
That's how it works on GTA.
Shut up.
Three versions of the special vehicles that are going to be introduced. I am excited for, but they're not going to have any customization, but they have cool features. One of them is the technical Aqua, which is essentially the current technical in the game. It's going to be amphibious and can go on water, so that's very interesting. The Rat Buggy, of course, from Fast and Furious 6. And the Nagasaki Laser Aqua. So that's a quad, amphibious quad. Is there anything that you might actually like about these vehicles?
Iggy, calm down.
Joey! Small technical difficulties, everybody. Looks like Joey just disappeared from the podcast.
Sorry.
Did my you brother. Hear what I said, or did I have to repeat myself?
I kind of did.
All right. Which from these vehicles, right? Is there any one that you might be interested in?
The one I'd mainly be interested in is, well, obviously the Porsche, like anybody.
No.
But.
No. You dummy?
The vehicles.
Right, let me. The vehicles are the current technical Aqua, which is going to be a current technical that can go on water. The Ramp Buggy from Fast and Furious 6.
Oh, those! Okay,
and
yeah.
The Nagasaki Blazer.
Yeah,
Aqua,
those.
Which is
those. I know. Shut up. I want the ramp buggy from Forza. I mean, not Forza. Jeez.
Wow.
Fast and Furious.
Someone has been spending too much time on Xbox.
Yeah, shut up. You're just mad you don't have one. Anyway. But yeah, I think it'd be the ramp buggy because just that you could have a lot of fun with that thing.
Can you imagine the amount of trolls there's gonna be on the lobby?
You could launch your friends into the air. You could use it as a bike ramp.
For trolling.
But who cares? It's fun.
I know. But then looking at the end of the list, there are three other vehicles, which is the Boxster V5, the Comet 3, so there might be another version of the Comet, and of course the LG 2. Now the LG 2 probably is the R34, so we're getting another version of an LG, the LG we have right now in the game, and there's the LG 2, which is probably the R34. But that's essentially the car list, the leaked car list that they released on the internets. But let's move on to the a little debate that we had before, which was
the missions for buying and selling vehicles.
Thank you for reminding me. So in the missions, if no one has heard about it, the missions essentially what you're gonna have to do is, of course, not break the cars. If you break the cars, you're gonna have to pay for them. And what essentially is going to happen, right? When you're going to be going on a sellout mission, people can actually steal your cars and put them in your own in their own warehouse, which, in my opinion, it's kind of better than destroying the valuables. At least someone's taking it. But Joey, on the other hand, doesn't agree about it.
I just think that you know, nowadays the little kids are on PS4 or Xbox playing Grand Theft Auto. You know how mad they get if you even just hit them with your car. They just, "What up, dude? What happened?" And then they just go on a tantrum, and then their parents walk in, "Hey, get off that! Hey, what is that?" But and then you have these 34-year-old dudes coming into your lobby and just blowing them up or killing them and taking their stuff, and then, "Hey, why you do that, dude?"
That's probably me. I will confess, I'll probably do that.
But, and then it's just annoying because they get in a jet and you're screwed either way.
But here's the thing. An argument to debate your argument is a lot of people, including me, when they want to do CEO missions or even biker sellout points shit, they find a public session on themselves. In fact, I'm in a public session on my own, and I've been here for the past 2 hours.
I mean, then that's perfectly fine. Then you do you. But if you're in a session alone, congratulations. If you're in a session with a few friends, congratulations. You found your own session and you can do all that and be perfectly safe. But that only works until somebody joins that session or one of, let's say you're streaming. One of your viewers comes into your session and starts screwing with you, then you lose any money you spent trying to get those vehicles, as well as you lose the chance at selling those vehicles properly.
The vehicles that you're going to be storing in the warehouse are going to spawn in the game, so you're literally not buying anything. You're just waiting for the vehicle to spawn. And just go and get it.
But can we be sure that's the system they're going to go with?
That's the leaked system, how it's going to be.
That's leaked, but then when it's leaked and they find out, they're going to change that system or make it harder for them to spawn.
But the guy that leaked this was an ex-Rockstar employee, and he specifically said that they essentially worked on the CEO, improved it on the biker DLC, but then they're going to add the stuff that they experimented with the biker DLC, they're going to add it to the CEO. So this is going to be essentially CEO part two. And
if it's CEO part two, and you know how in CEO, quote unquote, part one, you had to buy the crates and then go get those crates and then sell those crates without dying.
This leak, which is, in my opinion, it's 95% legit.
There's a 50-50 shot because he's an ex.
It's a 50-50 shot now. But the stuff that he's been leaking are correct. He mentioned all the cards that are going to be in. He essentially mentioned what kind of system is going to be. This system is going to be way better because you're going to not be spending money on the cars and essentially getting money for kind of for free. Now, they could, as you said, they could change it just to say, look, this guy was wrong. Don't believe him. I completely 100% agree with that, that they could essentially change it for the last few minutes, like few test betas. But I still think that this will probably be the best DLC yet between bikers and the first CEO DLC to ever be introduced to GTA. Because you're bringing stuff that the fans want, which is wide body kits, expensive supercars, easy ways to make money, and you're essentially hitting kind of everyone. Okay, it would be perfect if they added in like the invite-only sessions, but they clearly said they will never add it in invite-only sessions because it defeats the whole purpose.
I mean, with that being said, there's still ways.
If you think about it, you're contrabanding cars in this DLC, right? It's not going to be easy, because if you steal a car in real life, you're being chased by the fucking cops, and the owner realized who you are and he's chasing you with another car. So, in a way, the game is showing the risks you can take.
Check your fucking phone. Beth is losing her shit. Anyway, that's what I was going to say. The CEO DLC, that was supposed to be an easy way to make money too. But you didn't get much off of that. And that really kind of made people mad.
Wait. You're saying 2.5 million is not enough?
Debatable. That's 2.5 million is debatable. Because you did...
probably the best system ever.
But you still had to use that 2.5 million... to purchase either another HQ or something like that, but then,
arguing that argument, the biker DLC introduced, of course, the biker stuff. You're losing 30 grand every 45 minutes. 30 grand is a lot of money.
So is losing 2.5 million on a simple little HQ.
But that's why then you take advantage, right, of the the double money and RP adversary modes. Like, those can make you a lot of money.
Like, they can, but do they ever really?
They do, Joey. Like, let's be honest, right? They do. Like, I made last week, when it was Double Money and RP were on kill quota, I mean, at least by the end of Friday, 5.5 million for sure. And that is if you have a good team You're always winning, and you know essentially what you're doing, which
never
is
invited me to that asshole.
It wasn't my fault, asshole.
Could have texted me, asshole.
But that's pretty much it, because there is best ways to make money, and of course there is worse ways to make money. I've of course will probably never agree, audience, me and Joey, about this subject, because of course we're both saying good thing, like agreeing on the same things, but of course we're going to be agreeing with our sub, like, debates, and not agreeing with the other person's debates.
Fuck you. Anyways. We have the same mindset, it's just we have different opinions on certain things. Shut up. Suck my dick.
Pretty much. So, I think we pretty much covered everything all in this podcast. Do you want to say anything else before we end this podcast, Joey?
Hit me up on Twitch, yo. Join me in 2012, just saying.
Yeah, hit Joey on Twitch as well. We will be live streaming as well. The DLC when it drops on Tuesday. We'll probably be pre-streaming before the DLC drops, so we'll gather a bit of money with our audience as well. We'll be the full crew, so if you guys would want to join, again, you can hit Joey on Twitch, or you can even hit me on Twitch at funkmonkey_01. That's pretty much it, guys. Thank you very much for watching. You, Joey, say goodbye.
Goodbye!
And we'll see you guys in the next podcast. Thank you.
Deuces.